Constellations DAG is one of the first of its kind, being a feeless layer zero blockchain. It caught some attention from some really big fish, such as the US Air Force, and even landing a partnership with another big crypto project known as Quant. In this video, I will quickly be going over what their goals are, what they're trying to solve, along with unique key features, which makes them completely different compared to other projects in the space. I will also be ending the video on some concerns that I've seen about the project, because we all know crypto is extremely risky and is very important to hear both sides of anything before you invest. Welcome back to the channel, guys. It's your boy Crypto Houdini with DeFi Finance, and remember, none of this is financial advice. If you'd like to, check out our Discord in the description below, where we discuss different projects and investing strategies in real time. But now, with that being said, let's get into the video. So what DAG is really trying to accomplish is processing the world's big data. And if you don't know, big data is anything that could be measured and or recorded in a large quantity. So basically everything and anything on the internet, like videos, pictures, your favorite color, or even how many times you click on and off of a website, that is all considered big data. But they plan on doing this by creating a one-stop ecosystem for all of the projects, for all other projects to build their blockchains on. And as you can see with this article right here, 90% of the world's big data was generated in the last 2 years. And if you can see in this article right here, it was written in 2019. We are currently in 2022, so you can just imagine how much more data has been produced since this article's last update. This just goes to show how massive an ever-growing market that Constellations is going after, which is why it caught the attention of the US Air Force, since they are one of the large producers of big data in the world. This alone separates DAG from a lot of other projects out there, because while most projects in the crypto space are trying to fight to be top-notch blockchain so people can buy, sell, trade, and even build in their community, DAG is trying to create an entire ecosystem for all projects to interact. For instance, Binance and Ethereum are two completely separate blockchains with different coding, so whatever is built on one blockchain, it makes it extremely tedious and difficult to trade and interact with the other blockchain. And this is where Constellation steps in, because instead of another blockchain, they use a feeless tech called the Hypergraph Network, or otherwise known as DAG, which stands for Directed Acyclic Graph, which is not new technology. It's actually been around for quite some time. This is just one of the first projects to pioneer and integrate the technology into the crypto, which we will all be going over later on to the video. But yes, guys, this is a feeless network, which allows for completely separate blockchains to interact with each other, but still allow them to operate completely freely and independent from one another. Constellations is able to do this because of a very unique way that their nodes interact. But hold on, guys, let's take a step back and remember how a node was originally intended to be used. So as you can see here, anytime a transaction occurs on a blockchain, a block is created, which is sent out to be verified by different nodes until one is able to solve the algorithmic problem, which allows it to add the next block on the chain, completing the transaction. And I want you guys to look at this arrow opposite to what you see them as, pointing towards the block instead of the node, because again, they are all competing against each other to create the next block on the blockchain. Now, this is wonderful technology, which allowed for incredible security between transactions, which has solved a lot of problems with our current financial system. But there are a few problems this model faces, and that is only one transaction can be verified at a time, which causes a bottlenecked effect. So the more transactions and people on a network, the higher the chances for congestion and increased gas fees for on that blockchain. Also, the way blockchain nodes work, they use a large amount of energy to process transactions. And I found this picture and I thought it was pretty cool, you know. And if you guys enjoy the content so far, you know, go ahead and leave a little like and a little comment about the picture if you will. But unfortunately, this picture is completely false. There's a lot of projects coming out saying that they have such low gas fees and fast transactions, and people even speculate that one of them can be an ETH killer. But I would argue that if all blockchains follow the same model described previously, they could all run into the same problem with high gas fees and congestion. And I believe the reason why we don't see it right now is because none of the projects have even close to the same amounts of volume or transactions as Ethereum, being that Ethereum is the second most popular blockchain to retail investors. But regardless of all this, if all of retail was to get onto crypto right now to start building, it would cost an insane amount of gas fees every transaction across all networks, because the blockchain can only process one transaction at a time. And this is the problem that Constellations is able to solve with the way their nodes interact with each other. So as you can see, the blockchain works in a linear fashion, only moving in one direction when solving transactions, even when it's being forked. So all the nodes on a blockchain are fighting each other to place the next node on the block, compared to DAG, which allows for multiple transactions to occur and be solved at the same time. Now, you guys might have to replay this because it might get a little confusing, but they are able to do this because before a node is able to complete a transaction, it first has to verify other transactions from randomly assigned nodes. And this process takes very little computing power, which solves one of the problems crypto faces, which is energy consumption. But once that node is done verifying other transactions, its transactions is sent out so other nodes can verify it. And this is what creates the interlocking web that you see here. So the more people that is on the DAG network, the faster and more secure DAG becomes, which makes it infinitely scalable, guys. Yes, infinitely scalable. But another thing that's completely separates DAG from other blockchains is the way that their nodes are rewarded. As we all know, there is proof of work, which requires supercomputers to do the mining on the network, which is very costly and very energy consuming. Then there's also proof of stake, which again is very costly because the nodes with the most funds are prioritized. With Constellations, this is all about proof of reputation. So that means the longer you've been active and in the ecosystem, the more you will be rewarded and more governance that you will have in the ecosystem, which is a nice switch compared to the other two, making it more community-based by building a reputation within a network compared to you competing with other supercomputers or competing with other wealthy stakeholders for to be able to mine the next block on the chain. So yeah, guys, this is how DAG plans to process the world's big data, by using a feeless ecosystem that is infinitely scalable and more effective with the more people on the network, along with their proof of reputation, which is more community-based node system for the OGs of the projects, compared to proof of work, which again requires super expensive, which requires expensive supercomputers, and that also requires a huge amount of energy, or proof of stake that also requires a large amount of money to be effective. But this is their homepage, guys. I highly suggest you guys click through it. They even have a little chart comparison right here. Hold on, if I can find it. A little chart comparison right here that you guys could go through and just check out. There's a lot of cool little things that they have going on. And this is the team, guys, with the CEO right here, Ben Jorgensen. Sorry if I said his name wrong. And there's here is a list of the companies that they are also working with. You see the US Air Force being here. And this is also another list of some of the other crypto projects that they are working with. Also, if you guys would like to hear about the project from the horse's mouth, this is their YouTube channel, and they go into depth explaining how everything works. And they are pretty consistent, with the most recent video being 3 weeks ago. And this other channel called Star Collective really paints a clear picture of how DAG works and what they wish to accomplish in simple terms, which while also using real world examples. I highly recommend you guys check out both of these channels. Their main channel is if you would like to hear more of a technical and up-to-date side of the project. And this channel right here, Stardust Collective, this is if you would like to get a broader understanding of the whole project in general, especially if you want to see what they're trying to achieve. But especially this video right here, guys, I highly suggest you guys check out this video right here, Dag Explained in 15 Minutes by Andre Sewer. Sir, I'm sorry if I said his name wrong as well. But moving on, this is just an article showing their partnership with Quant right here. And again, I'll leave all the links in the description below. And this is a grant that they received from the U.S. Air Force right here. This is just showing it. And this is another article showing that they have moved into phase two of the grant that they have received. So currently DAG is sitting at around 5 cents, just below 5 cents, and their current node is quite pricey, so $12,420. So yes guys, it is quite pricey, but compared to it now, compared to if you would have had to buy a node all the way up here, I believe this is a great time to accumulate and buy. Because me personally, I think it's just a good project. I personally like the project. But please do not take my word for it, guys. Not until you hear all the negative sides to the project that we will be going over. So again, guys, also please make sure you're doing your own research. But this article right here, this just explains how DAG has always been around. It's been the history and use cases of DAG, how it's been around a part of human history and how it actually aligns with the way that nature actually works, which again I will be adding all in the description below. But now is time for the negative arguments to DAG. So shout out to this man right here, Crypto Weatherman, as he talks about some of his takes on DAG and some of the few downsides he sees towards it. And I strongly think that it is needed in such a volatile space for you to hear both sides of a project. And one of the first points that he has is that DAG is only awarded a grant from the Air Force to see what they can do and not a partnership, which a lot of people advertise about DAG, which is completely true. My only argument to that is I don't believe that getting a grant from the Air Force is an easy task, especially with all of crypto not being fully adopted or regulated by the government yet. So I just think that this is not something to just look over. And they also have moved on to phase two with the grant, so only time will really tell how they do with that. I can also agree though that DAG has things posted on their website that can be a little misleading, like them talking about them just advertising the Amazon Web Services without any physical proof of it. I asked the community and got nothing, but one of the leaders from the Discord responded back to me and saying that he would be getting more info on that towards the end of the year and beginning of the new year. So I do agree that they should specify who they are working with and have proof before putting it on their website, because honestly, it's just a bad look. Another thing he said is that they talk a lot about redefining Web3, which a lot of projects have said and often repeat, all while Web3 is not fully even developed yet. And I can agree that a lot of projects do say the same thing and it does get repetitive. But my only argument for that is crypto is fairly new and developing, and the best way to stay on top is trying to be ahead of the curve. So if they think they have what it takes, I don't see anything wrong with them trying to have a visionary outlook on their project. He also talks about the white paper and how it is extremely hard to understand. I should have had it up, but sorry about that, guys. But it's on this website somewhere. But I really do agree with that. The white paper, trying to understand DAG reading the white paper is not simple at all. And it can be a deterrent for a lot of retail. They should redo the white paper and try to break it down a bit more so it's easier to digest. They do have a YouTube channel which explains in depth how it works. It's just for a retail perspective. Nobody really wants to sit down and watch an hour long video for you to explain the tech. Everybody's busy and prefers simple and easy. So an updated white paper and an updated explanation is definitely needed for this project. One of the last things he also talks about is the transaction volume. And he does say that the transaction volume is low. And I could agree the transaction volume is low, but again, we are in a bear market and I don't think transaction volume really determines the quality of a project. I personally feel like transaction volume, it just shows how many eyes are on a project. And we're, again, we're in a bear market, but excuse me, time will tell once we get more adoption, but it is best to see it in a bull run again, so we could really determine what and how this project really takes on for the rest of retail. But some of my concerns are that they could have a bit of a better layout for the website. I think this part is smooth, but the way that their team side is set up, it could definitely use some improvement, make it a little bit more neater with people's roles being more easily displayed, people's pictures more easily displayed, and also their marketing can improve. And we are in a bear market, and they have been putting out videos on YouTube and been a bit active on Twitter. I just think that in order to attract retail, you need to have very good marketing, especially with the way that their hypergraph works. It works its best with the more people on the network, and you need retail for that. But this is my take on DAG, the good, the bad, and the ugly. But thanks for making it this far and watching the video completely. But this is your boy Crypto Houdini with DeFi Finance, and thank you guys, and have a wonderful day. Peace.